We are moving to our next unit, that is angles. First itself, I will tell about parallel lines. You already know what you mean by parallel lines. You can see two lines are there. So two lines on a plane that do not intersect, that is parallel lines. So you can see next one, transversal. If any lines, okay, you can see that two parallel lines are there, and if any other line that intersect this two lines, that is transversal. You can see the figure. Yeah, two lines has been given and one line is been cutted by that two lines, so that is transversal. So it's given there, any line that intersect two other lines in the same plane. Okay, so how many angles are formed when a transversal intersect two lines? How many angles you can see from here? See, this is one angle, right? This one, another one, another one, another one. See, these all are angles. So how many angles has been formed? 8 angles has been formed here. Now the next one is corresponding angles. Whenever you are hearing about corresponding angles, you have to think the letter F. Okay, keep in your mind about F. I will tell you how. See, this will be your question. Okay, from here you have to tell which all are corresponding angles. So you have to think about the alphabet F. So how you can think F? See, this one, from here you can draw one F, right? Then from here you can draw one F, right? I will show you. Wait, see one figure is like this. See, I drawn here, this one is F. That means, see, inside this D and this H is corresponding angles. That means this D and H is equal. Okay. Now you can see the next one. See the next one. I drawn F here. That means inside this C and this G equal. Okay. These all are angles. Okay. See, that's why I put up degree. C degree. Because it is angle, that's why I put degree. Now see, for the next one, I drawn F here. See, so E, angle E and angle A equal. This is F. Third one, you can see I drawn here also F. Okay, this one F. So inside this angle and inside this one are equal. That means angle E and angle A are equal. Now see, for the fourth one, again I drawn F like this. See, inside F is there and B is there. So angle F and angle B equal. Okay. Now see, from here, this was our picture. So you have to check for F. Okay. So how many corresponding pairs we got? A and E. So A and E corresponding, D and H corresponding, B and F, and C and G. Now the next one is alternate angles. So for the corresponding angles, you have to think about the alphabet F. For alternate angles, you have to think the letter Z. Okay, you have to think the letter C. I will show you. This is our question. Okay, from this question, you have to write which all are alternate angles. So I will show you here. See, I have drawn here Z. It's not perfect Z, but you have to draw like this. Okay, this is Z. See the inside here, this Z corner, this one, and inside this Z's corner, these two angles are equal. That means D and F are equal. Then the next one, see here, I drawn Z like this also. Yeah, inside the corners. See, Z's this corner and this corner. So C and E equal. Okay, now you can see from here how many pairs of alternate angles you are getting. Two pairs you are getting. That means D and F you are getting, then C and E also. Okay, don't make mistake for these alternate angles and corresponding angles. Corresponding angles, you have to think the alphabet F, and for the alternate angles, you have to think the letter Z. Now I am going to one question. So you can see the diagram shows two parallel lines and two transversals. you have to fill in the missing lines. These all are missing lines, okay? Whatever I wrote with a red color, it's the missing letters. Okay, I will show you the diagram. This is the diagram. See, two parallel lines are there and two transversal lines are drawn there. Okay, now from here you have to write the missing angles. So see here, C and dash are corresponding angles. You can see C is here. C and which alphabet is corresponding angles? Whenever you are getting corresponding angles, what you have to think? You have to think about F. So you have to think about F. I will draw. See, this is F. This is F. Correct? So what it will come? C corresponding. That means it will come I. So which is corresponding angle to C? C and I are corresponding angles. Now B, you have to find C and which angle is alternate. So see from here, C alternate means you have to keep in your mind about the letter Z. So start from here, here, here. So in this corner C is there. In this corner what is coming? It's F. So C and F are alternate angles. Now the next question is, you have to find D and which alphabet is corresponding angles. See, for D, this is D, right? So you have to think about corresponding angles is given, so you have to think about F, right? See, D is here, only this angle. So start from here and draw F like this. Okay, don't think that okay this is F. No, why? Because it's not given like fully, it's not given like this is angle D. No, only this much is angle D. So you have to think like F like this only. Okay, that means which is corresponding angles? D corresponding means it is coming L. So D and L are corresponding angles. So the answer will come D and L are corresponding angles. Okay, you have to think about F and you have to find the answer. Then D and which number is alternate angle? So you have to think the alphabet Z. This is D, correct? So start from here. This is your Z. That means D here, and inside what is coming? G is coming. So D and G are alternate angles. So for this question, the answers are these all things. C and I are corresponding angles. Then F and C and F alternate angles. Then D and L corresponding angles. Then D and G alternate angles. Okay, you have to practice this very well, because next year also this is very important. So you have to practice it more. If possible, write this question in your notebook. Okay, now next question, you can see in the diagram the size of one angle is 62 degrees. Copy and complete these two sequences. So here you can see the diagram, two parallel lines are there and one transversal line is there. Yeah, and they had given that this angle is 62 degrees. You have to find corresponding angles are equal. So angle, you have to find angle B and you have to find angle D also. How we will find the answer? See, you know this is 62 degrees, right? So they said about corresponding angle. So you have to think about F. So start from here. I will draw like this. So this is the F. So if this is 62 degrees, what will be B? B will be also 62 degrees. Why? Because it is corresponding angles. It's given there. Because corresponding angles are equal, so the angle B equal 62 degrees. Now alternate angles are equal, so angle D equal. So this is D. Yeah, we know this one is 62 degrees. It is alternate angle. So you have to think about the letter Z. Start from here. I will draw like this. That means this one and this one will be same. That means angle D is also 62. Why? Because of alternate angles are equal. Now you can do this as homework. Page number 52, question number 1 and 3. Okay. Practice more and you have to be very careful. Keep watching this video one or two times. It's okay. After that, do these answers. If you have any doubt, please ask me. Okay, thank you.